The views and opinions expressed on any program are those of the persons appearing on the program and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the New Media Factory. Some programs on this network might include strong images and language and may not be suitable for all audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Alam mo, we'll have to start talking about our entrance every time on the show.
Dapat naka ano, rehearse na.
Dapat naka rehearse na, no? Kasi si Marvin, I can see the disappointment on his face.
Every time
it's like, guys, why did I get you? Ganun eh. Tingnan mo, he's not even denying it.
Hindi siya umili.
Yeah. Well, welcome you guys to PurveyrTV.
And guess who's back?
I'm back, like Sebastian Beck.
What?
Sorry. Like the classical composer or the singer of... No, okay. Let's not have this conversation. Hi, I missed you guys. I'm clingy. Well, I was sick last week, so I wasn't able to go here. But it's fun to be back. How are you?
I'm good. Ito. Okay naman. Like, I tried to push through last week. Diba? Uh-huh. Shit, wala si Joyce. Paano ba gagawin
walang
natin?
Walang epal, no?
Hindi, parang tahimik lang namin. Eh, last week. Hindi siya like lively and shit. Pero kinaya.
It was fun kasi I tuned in
na. Pero nandun ka sa chat box. So may party sa chat box.
Pumaparty ako sa chat box na was like, Kuya RJ, gwapo mo naman foes.
Wow! Ikaw ba yun? Ikaw lang ginabi.
Ako yung nagjajaja posts dun sa chat box. And I'm online on the chat box now too.
So, but of course, because of that, may surprise tayo mamaya sa mga viewers, diba? Since wala ka last week, alam ko parang may gagawin ka mamaya.
Ano mong gagawin ka mamaya?
Yeah.
Kunyari. Yes, I'll be singing later on.
Yes.
Tsaka, sorry. Yes, na man. Ano, ang gagawin ko lang, bigla lang ko kakanta. Because like, ito yung story niya na, I was eating in Mang Inasal kanina. Na nakabasag pa ako ng plato. Tapos, galing. Tumawag sa akin si... As in, literally, nabasag ko siya na parang it slid off and then, nag-pack, it cracked. So, sorry. Ang loud ng boses ko. Anyway. And then, Marvin called me and he was like...
Oy. Right away? Like, after...
Yeah, after the incident happened, he was like, hey, pwede ko ba kumunta mamaya sa show? Kasi wala na akong choice eh. Ikaw na lang. Wala.
So,
yeah, he technically told me that, dude, I have no other choice
ikaw
but to make you sing.
Oy.
Si RJ ba yan?
Bakit ako?
Hey man, don't tell Joyce, but she's our last choice. So anyway. But it's fun. Yeah, I'll be performing two songs later. So please don't judge me. Yeah, so I'm excited. But of course, aside from that, what I'm excited about is our two guests today.
Yes.
Can you tell us more about it, RJ?
Yes, well, we have two guests for today's show. One of them is... a retailer store for sneakers and another one is a good friend of ours, actually our neighbor. Yo, I have my roommate here, George, come here. tell something about our good friend who's our guest for today.
What's up, George?
What's up, Joyce? Well, oh my God!
Oh my God!
His name is Diego Castillo, and he's just fucking awesome, dude. Like, when you watch him, you're just like... And that's pretty much it, man. Donuts, guys.
Yes, and since George already told our viewers who our guest is, then it's just fair to say that our other guest is
Diego Castillo
and Gabby's closet. So
yes.
Yeah, that's right. And of course, we got an upcoming event this coming Saturday.
I thought they were gonna cover us. Yung pala, gigilid
and it is called Platform. Well, we've done Platform. This is the third showcase, tama ba? Third or fourth? Well, Okay, pop-up platform siya. So it's called Platform Showcase. It's gonna be held at M Cafe on the 20th from 4 to 10 p.m. So it's all about urban fashion, art, music, culture. And we got performances by...
We got performances by Nix Damp, P-Rec 1, Deuce Manila, Katsi Lee, and guest DJs. I was actually able to go to the last platform in Ronak as well. Yeah. It was fun because I got myself a nice pair of shoes from Feet for a Queen, whatever, some store, and Viva La Manica. Nice. Like, I got a lot of cool stuff. So if you guys want to find, like, cool finds, like really, really nice finds that you can't see on ready-to-wear stores or whatever, you can check it out right there. So please check
it out. Make sure that you guys drop by 4:20 from 4 to 10 p.m. That's platform at M Cafe. Greenbelt. Yep. So what else we got?
What else we got?
I'm well, on the... I think...
Yeah. On the chat box. I'm on the, oh, wait lang ah. Kailangan natin i-discuss to. Because Marvin posted, meron daw kaming summer episode. So, I plead.
Oh, let's sign the petition.
Yes.
Yeah.
Let's sign the petition.
We were talking about it last
you were?
Yeah, we were talking about
you,
it last
are we going to do the inflatable pool?
Okay. Kaya yan.
Kaya yan. Guys, ito ang gagawin namin. Yeah, we are going to be needing inflatable pools. And beach balls and pina coladas, okay? So if you guys have ano inflatable pools, kami tigisa kami na inflatable pools ni RJ. Tapos ay isang pool kami ni RJ na inflatable pool. Tapos sa kabilang pool yung guests, okay? Yes. And RJ's gonna wear a bikini.
No, what? No one told. I didn't get that memo.
I know, right? Congrats. Now you know.
Wow. Okay. Magkakasakit ako sa episode.
Sobrang lamig.
The chat box ako.
I'm gonna be absent. Okay. Game.
So yeah. It's just well, right now before we introduce our first guest for the show, well, we just want to talk about the sneakers and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, would you like to tell something about that, Joyce?
Sneakers?
Sneakers, like all of that stuff.
Ooh, sneakers. I don't know, because I have really ugly shoes. I love sneakers because before I used to dance before, so I always needed like really nice pair of sneakers, but I never actually got what? Fancy skater shoes, yung parang hindi ako nagsiskate ever. But it's just really nice and it's so dressy, like even if you're just wearing a plain shirt or whatever. So I'm excited for this guest because I have no idea where to actually get like legit really nice shoes that could be feminine and still midge rock. Ang dami ko sinabi, no? Kala mo wala ako alam sa sneakers. Meron na.
kahit naka, ano ka.
Kahit naka espadrilles ako. Thank you, Poppy Shoes. I was kidding about the ugly note.
So yun, aside from that, well, I think that a lot of people would be interested to listen to us today since, like, these guys have been doing it for a while and I've been seeing a bunch of, like, posts coming from artists and other people that these guys hooked them up really good. So, yeah, our first guest for today's show, we got Gabby's Closet in the building. Oh, video mo muna? Okay. So, whose video are we showing right now? Okay. We got a video from Gabby's Closet and after the video, we got them up in here. PurveyrTV, one.
Thank you.
Yon. So there you go. That was a video from Team Gabby's Closet, who we got right here. To my left, we got Papo and Bryan. So yeah.
What's up, guys?
What's up? So yeah, Papo and Bryan, tell us how you guys became a part of Gabby's Closet, man.
Well, we used to like buy stuff from him. We're members of the sneaker community, so we used to buy stuff from him. We eventually became friends, and now, like, he started out the shop. We're helping out.
Yeah, we were clients before, and he talked to us. He said he wanted to open a shop. So sure, we're always here to help you. Yeah, he's based in California. That's why we are the one here, not him.
So when you guys started out, you guys were out here while he was out in the States, or did he come out here to visit and then he just hooked you guys up with bears?
He used to hook us up with bears, send them here, we'll pick it up at his place. But he eventually started the shop out, then he just goes here occasionally. So he visits and checks out the shop, brings some stocks here, sends in some stuff. So
nice. So after that, you guys became a part of the team?
Yeah, we promote him, we help him out, you know, suggest things.
So while you guys were talking earlier, George and you guys were talking earlier, well, we have the question here, why the name Gabby's Closet? So
it was named after his daughter, Gabby. That's why, it was his inspiration, I guess, for the hustle, you know. He was telling me before that when he was young, he can't afford to buy them shoes, but now... He started collecting them Jordan. So not just Jordan, yeah. He's into a lot of brands as well. But, of course, he was inspired by the goat himself. Yeah, and of course, the name Gabby, the daughter. Yeah, everything is for the family, of course. That's what we want to as well, to promote. It's a family store, yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's cute. So do you get requests for little sneakers?
Yes, of course. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yes, yes.
How young is the youngest customer?
Infants,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Because I find it really cool when I see a dad, that's my little boy, yes, and they have the same pair of shoes, right?
Yep.
So that's nice. They can actually order that from you.
Yeah, he brings in booties and the bonnets for the 0 to 6 months.
Oh
you
know? My god.
Yeah, from that young until we have infant sizes, then the youth sizes. He brings in everything, you know. He tries to cater to everyone.
Yeah, that's cute because ngayon na notice ko that people are actually starting to be a part of this whole scene. That they're putting the fashion forward.
But you can hear me. Is that how loud my voice is? Umaabot kay RJ. Oh my gosh. Okay, so anyway, I was talking about, having infants with their sneakers. But what's always boggled me is that there are so many, like I said, from the dads to the kids, mga in love sila with sneakers. So I'm sure for you guys are also in love with the whole collecting and, just putting it out there. How did it start for you?
Well, it's basically some of my memories when I was a kid.
Uh-huh.
So I used to buy some pairs. Then eventually, Jordan brand decided to retro these pairs. So I decided to, these were part of my childhood. So I gotta have them because they were very nostalgic. And, they were part of me as I was growing up.
Yeah, that's fine.
I got hooked because of the hip-hop culture. Yeah. MTVs, you'll see them, Tupac Shakur wearing Jordans. Okay, I must have them. Yeah, I must wear them. It's part of my daily grid already. So, yeah, that's how it started for me.
In the 90s, it was always if you have the same kind of sneakers and the same kind of silver chain, then you're cool. Yeah.
I think I had that phase.
Yeah, but you had that phase, and you were wearing a durag even if you didn't. Yes, what? My voice? Okay. It's okay. It's felt like no. Okay. You always had the durag even if you don't have a
time
pro,
na durag ako before.
Diba? My brother also.
Yeah. Yeah. Guilty as charged.
And then it also came to a phase na parang you had the bandana inside and then a cap. I knew because I did those too. So everyone's guilty. That's nice, you guys.
So aside from sneakers, what else do you guys carry in the store?
Clothing line from the States, we have I Am King, Accomplish. We have a brand for jeans, Rustic Dime, for skaters. Yeah. These are new products. We did had a launch before in Ronak, Secret Fresh for Rastaclad and I'm King. It describes the current scene right now, which is street. I'm King, most of their designs are based on urban fashion as well.
So most of the stuff that you guys have inside the store is from abroad?
Not actually, but we started out having local shirt owners or clothing
brands.
Lines, yeah, local brands to consign it, to be consigned in the store. Like we have KPR clothing, black and white, which is what I'm wearing right now, my clothing line, Stash clothing, and Altitude. So we started out without those brands. Now we're eventually trying to fuse the American brands with the Filipino brands for the Filipino culture or the Filipino urban culture to like, step it up a notch or raise the bar when it comes to urban fashion. Yeah.
Right now we have Fresh and part of Soul City well.
Ah, so you guys are part of
Like we were getting we are open for anyone who is like independent or locally made, and if they would like to consign their product in Gabby's Closet, we're open to that one.
That's cool, man. That's cool.
Like the purpose of the store, the objective of Gabby's Closet is to preserve the culture of the Filipino urban culture and try to fuse it out with some fashion from other countries, so that you know the Philippine fashion can be like taken up a notch, can be like we can raise the bar with regard to that. So
one up.
Yeah, we gotta like step it up a notch. Now wearing like basketball shorts and rubber shoes, yeah. You know, try to look better, try to enhance the culture.
Who knows? Probably we'll have our own agenda. And who knows, right?
Yeah, true. So, since we are talking about sneakers, like, personal question: what are your favorite pair right now? Yeah, what's your favorite? Pair?
Still, first love Jordan ones. Really classic. I love them when they turn yellow, the midsoles and such. The crease doesn't really matter to me. For me, 94s. Of course, I was influenced by the same team, Team LMS, so respect to them.
Yeah. Well, for me, it's probably Jordan 12 taxis because I had those when I was a kid. So those were the pairs that really started it for me. So that pair is very nostalgic. So that's the pair that, you know, I wouldn't trade for anything.
I have no idea what those are.
But you should start your own game.
Fashion
I know, But you know, I don't have an idea what it is, but hearing it from people who are so passionate about it and who are so inclined in taking care of what they love to do and what they are doing right now, it makes you want to learn more about it.
Yeah.
Right?
It's
nice. True. Because you were talking about like even if it turns yellow, because that always happens to your sneakers, right? And you love it when that happens. And those little details are so important nowadays. And I have no idea what they are, but I'm gonna find out maybe when I check out your stores.
Please.
Where is the store again?
It's located in Unit 2M1 Lee Gardens Condominium, Shaw Boulevard, Mandaluyong City.
Justin Shaw.
What's the schedule for the store, man? So just so that people know.
Okay. We open 12:30 till 8 Tuesdays to Sundays, and then Monday 12 to 6.
Yeah. All right. So you can check it out. My little cousin is coming home soon. He's a little boy. He loves playing basketball. I'm gonna get him a new pair of sneaks. Maybe I can check it out from you guys.
Yes, of course.
Cool. Yeah.
So right now, since you guys do like go to the store off as much, right?
Yes, of course. We try to go to the store as much as we can. We have our own schedule, so we try to like fit it in, so you know we can watch him out, you know, check out new brands and talk and suggest the brands to bring here and the suggestions for the new clothings that you know or the new clothes that they're gonna release.
So when it comes to what is in demand right now, what is the pair that like people usually ask for when you guys are in the store?
Right now, our market is the girls. Like, women are into the sneaker game.
Yay.
Right now.
Yes.
We've been getting orders for Jordans. Most of the girls really love the Jordans.
I know.
Second to Jordans, Kobe, and then, sorry, I'm a LeBron fan. Third is only LeBron. It's Kobe and then Jordan. That's it. Yeah.
The Jordans are nice. I actually saw a black one. Tapos it has like a neon blue and pink lining. What Jordan is that? Yeah.
Neon blue and pink.
Yeah. It was something, I don't know. I saw a girl. I was like, what are your shoes? They're so nice.
Oh, I think that's the Jordan 4 Vivid Pink.
Ah, there. And she was like, oh my gosh, like I ordered it from the States. Yeah. But it was really nice. So I didn't judge her. Yeah. I'd like to have that too.
So you now know who to ask for.
I now know who to ask. You just describe it. They're like a questioning machine. It's colored yellow and blue. What is it?
So what do you guys think about the local sneaker scene right now, man? Because, we think that it is, like, progressing and it's flourishing. So how do you guys feel about that, man?
Well, in a way, it's becoming mainstream and famous and it's really progressing, but at the same time, there's a bad side to it, because the culture we're trying to preserve is significantly out of shape. Or right now, a lot of people have been reselling the pairs that were intended for some people, with all due respect to the other sellers right there. So we're trying to help out by promoting this. Getting them at retail, and some pairs really you can't buy at retail, so we're trying to look for good deals with that, you know.
Yeah. Ah, okay. So, do you guys have special projects that you work on? Like, do you do if they request a sneaker, pair of sneakers to you, and then you order it from the States or something like that?
We do hookups, if that is what you mean. Yeah. Last hookup that I did was someone was looking for a Supreme Air Force One. Yeah. I always ask them, give me at least a week or two to look for one. Because
mm-hmm.
some of the pairs are really hard to find, like, you know, the Yeezys too and such. Yeah. They're asking for a good price, but I let them know. Well, you know how it is.
Yeah.
It's not that
you really
easy.
You really can't get at the price you really want.
Uh-huh.
So it's quite, you know, it's a wallet buster. So it's ideally you get them at retail. But if you don't really get them on the release date, or you don't really work hard for the pair, mm-hmm. to get the pair, you line up or you you try to get them early, mm-hmm. it's going to be hard for you to find a pair at retail.
But, like, how do you look for it? Do you have store hookups already from the States or other places? Or, like, online stores as well?
We go around the States. My friend goes around, uh-huh. like, downtown L.A. He RC. Checks out all the shops there.
Yeah.
Sometimes we get our pair from local stores, like Riff. Mm-hmm. Riff L.A. I'm sure everyone's familiar with Riff. Sometimes if the pair is really hard to find, we check out Flight Club just hook someone up, you know. That's it.
That's great.
Yeah.
Well, what do you have, like, any advice for those like I who just want to start collecting really nice pair of sneakers as well? Because for my work, it's really hard because I'm always asked to wear heels because I'm so small. but you know, I sometimes do events that need me to be comfortable. So I still want to feel comfortable and nice, and you know, just make my own collection of sneakers. How do I start, like? Is there a way?
Well, if I was going to advise you, you go for the pairs you really like.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the pairs that, you know, would you... Because before you buy a pair, I suggest for all the viewers out there, before you buy a pair, you think about it at least 10 times.
Yeah.
If you really can't live without that pair, then you should buy it, you know?
Will it start like an addiction for me, because I easily get addicted
hope not.
To things?
It's just like us. We got hooked.
Yeah.
Trust me. It's a bad name for you to be for someone to call you a hype beast, but we are. I admit I was one before. Right now, the question regarding about how the game is game changing right now. A lot of people got hooked into runners aside from the Jordan, and people. Even if it's a simple Air Max 1, they would love to take pictures of their shoe wearing, or sometimes they're like splatter of water and they just step on it.
Yeah.
I know, it became a culture for them as well. Yeah, that's it. But again, it's okay if you're a hype beast, but learn, think twice before buying something.
Think twice.
You gotta
think
know
about
the ropes.
It.
Yes. history of the pair, you gotta know that.
You gotta know. And you gotta know if it fits your personality and all that jazz, right? But it's great. It's great to be part of that kind of culture and that kind of community, because it's just like art. It binds so many people, right?
Yes, yeah. I was able to get to know. It's like RZ.
Yeah.
Yeah. Commune days, man. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And you start your own community, talaga, because you get to know friends, you get to know people who are also into sneak. So that's great.
Of course, George.
Yeah, yes. George.
George.
Hey, man. What's up?
Hey, George.
Hi, guys.
So, as people who love sneakers, how much do you guys usually spend in a month for shoes, man? Because, like. Ooh. Cause that's the question that people would want to know, man. We all want to hear this.
Well, ideally, in a perfect world, you try to get the pairs on retail, so you buy them SRP. But if not, you know, some people would sell them 2,000 pesos higher. Like, for example, the pair is 7,500, you get them at 10,000. Some pairs are really hard to find, like years after, so they're like 20,000 pesos. So, but basically, as much as possible, I buy them at retail. So that's basic. The highest pair that I probably have is like a 12,000 peso pair, because I try to play it smart, you know, keep it low. You know,
how about you, Papo?
I think it was back in 2009 up to 2011. Those were crazy. Yeah. 3 years. Doing the math, I almost had a car. Like for
in a month.
Well, in a month, twice at least. There are two pairs at least. Two pairs online. Sometimes you see something local, you have to buy it. That's how crazy it is before.
Yeah, the sneakers ruined our life.
You know? Yeah, yeah, game changer. You know?
Yeah. Ruined your life, but building it right now, right? Yeah, building it back.
We are.
Well, to follow up with that, how many pairs of sneakers do you guys own present, dude?
Because it changes. You unload stuff. You know, you unload to reload. Sometimes you gotta let go of stuff to get new stuff. But I think the manyest I had was like 200.
200
but I had to like cut it down, because every day you gotta wear a new pair. And there are some pairs that it's gonna be your favorite, right? It's really gonna be your favorite. So you have to like, pwedeng maulit eh. You gotta, but nasisira eh. Sometimes they powder. Sometimes
crumble.
Yeah, they crumble. Yeah, it breaks my heart. You know, seeing them. So. Before that thing happens, you know, some pairs I thought of. You have to think really what you like. So right now it's probably 100 na lang ngayon sa akin. Mga ganun. But I know some people, they own more. They own like 500 pairs, 800 pairs, 1,000.
That's crazy, man.
That's crazy, man.
That's crazy. But
with respect to their game, probably they really want 1,000 pairs.
Yeah.
Like, is there?
And they got the money to blow.
Yeah. They got money to burn. So respect to them.
But is there a certain way of how you can like keep your shoes, or like? Because I heard, like, people have like sort of a storage room or whatnot.
With the right temperature.
Yeah, with the right. Yeah, all right? That stuff, man.
It's true.
Just for not the shoes to break.
Repertoire when it comes to that.
Uh-huh.
Best advice is, well, you can't keep them forever. Wear them. Wear your shoes, especially the retro Jordans. Wear them. Don't keep them. You know, buying, what do you call those?
Silica gel
won't help. Ziplocs, yes. We're in the Philippines, so dust is like everywhere, man. So better just wear your Jordan. So after like how many years, you won't be like regretting that I did not wear this and it's already crumbling. So yeah.
It's true.
Yeah.
But My take on that is, you gotta find a pair you really like, and you gotta wear it as much as you can. Like at least
once a month. You know, you gotta wear that pair so it doesn't really. Because when you wear your pair, it's life preserves. It's not like other things that the culture that we're in right now is quite. It's not really healthy because they're not like Rolex that appreciates, man. It's like when you wear them, yeah, it really.
It's like a car.
It's like a car, man. The depreciation is really high when it comes to shoes because you know it really gets beat up. So you have to you gotta preserve them. Well, for me, I at least turn on the aircon of my room. They're in my room, like for 8 hours a day. And keep it on timer. Timer na lang siya, nag-go off siya, nag-go on siya. Then I have a my closet naka display lang siya, you know. I don't try to keep them inside as Ziploc
or in boxes. No.
I just get a dehumidifier the silica gels, place them outside so it doesn't really dry up the shoe so much. Kasi if you put silica gels inside the shoe, it dries up. So you have to keep a little moisture to preserve the pears.
So it's like outside the box and the silica gel is outside, right?
Like,
beside the shoe.
Like,
it will be better if it's just in your room to, you know, absorb the humidity.
Yeah.
Hirap,
bro.
So mamaya
pag-uwi ko. It's hard, man.
It's like having
your shoes breathe. That's it.
They have to breathe, man. They're like the little people that you have to.
Or like
nurture.
Baka magtampo to, gagamitin ko to ngayon.
Para siyang girlfriend mo, kailangan mo siyang i-love enough pero wag masyado.
Oh yeah, it's true.
That didn't make sense, everyone.
How many pairs? 70. That's it. That's
70.
I stopped.
Dude, I have like 12. That sucks for me, man. I should really start my own sneakers, like my own collection.
It's hard to maintain that.
Yeah.
If you have 12 pairs, you gotta like, it's ideal. But if it goes higher, it's gonna be hard.
Yeah, you really it's like a responsibility because you don't you no, it's just true because
there was a time I was like putting in the calendar what I wore, like this one I wore Jordans today, this pair tomorrow.
You must have a rotation.
You have
there's
to wear everything.
Yeah. It's in the calendar that pero you know you really can't may mga araw na uulitin mo yung pair especially when it's your favorite.
Gusto niyo kapag gusto mo talagang suotin.
Yeah, man, it's really hard.
That's why your first advice when you're starting out is buy your favoritest pair.
Yeah.
All right.
So, is there anything else that you guys would is there anything else that you guys would want to tell the viewers out there, man? Like where can they see do you guys have a website? Where can they see more about Gabby's Closet?
Well, Facebook, we started there, Gabby's Closet, and of course, Gabby's Closet Manila. Website, yes, www.gabbysclosetmanila.com. Yeah,
you can check it. You can check us out also at Twitter and Instagram, Gabby's Closet. You can check Papo at the Subliminal, and Papo777 on Instagram, and me at Bryan Zafra. So that's it, man.
Any upcoming events that you guys are going to be in?
We just had our event. I think for our first anniversary, this coming June, we'll have an event. Well, where, we don't know. We're still planning it.
All right, man.
So I hope Revere will be there as well.
You gotta log in, like follow Gabby's Closet in the team Gabby's Closet to like find out.
All right, man. Thanks. And...
Oh, well, thank you guys for joining us this afternoon.
Thank you so much.
I learned a lot, for one, because
yes.
I know you're addicted to it as well. So I learned a lot. And for those kids who are like me, who just want to start out their own sneakers collection, please do listen to them.
Can we give a shout out?
Yes,
yeah,
of course.
Sure.
Of course.
We want to give a shout out to the crew, Kicks United, Team Pet Malu, Team LMS, HOH, Gabby's Closet in the store. Who else? The clothing line,
Dizzy.
Black and White.
Yep, it's Dizzy. Wants me to do a shout out for him. Mr. Shop
Mick
and
Jagger,
Go.
Yep. Genki and Cat. Yep. You know, Angry Birdie. You know, hi, all you guys watching.
Yeah, thank you guys for being here. Check out their online store and their store and shop.
Yep, shop.
Just find out on their Twitter and on their Instagram account. Thank you, boys.
Thank you.
It was fun.
So much, Joyce.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
RJ. Salamat, bro. And right now, before our next guest, we got a new music video up. It's called Back for More from Sandwich.
Yeah. Yeah.
Stay cool, fat, salt, and flame pala.
Para lahat may hawak na, ano?
From their Fat, Salt, and Flame album out now. And yes, with us yes, tonight is the very much sneakerhead as well.
Not as much as
our first guest.
Our first guest, man. There.
Yeah. We have Diego Castillo on the show.
Yeah. Oh my God. Oh my God.
That's right.
Oh my God.
Are you guys gonna kick me out?
No.
If we do that, okay, no, fine. All right.
We're actually bringing in George later on.
Yeah,
so
we
you
should.
Guys have to wait for that.
I can't wait. Like,
just, like.
I'm so amped right now.
You got your mic here. Well, thanks for having me.
For
I'm sorry.
You.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
Thanks for being here. We're so excited because parang sobrang perfect na tong episode na to for Diego kasi music plus sneaks.
I know.
Right?
I know.
Exactly.
And it's because Purveyor is about bands and DJs and arts and sneaks and culture and all that. Tapos si Diego lahat yung natap niya.
I actually think they were lying with this 75 bears.
Oh, 75 pears.
Liar!
Bakit,
more.
Diego, ilan yung pears mo?
De konti lang.
Yan. Ilan yung sayo, bro?
Magsalita.
Ilan yung sayo?
De konti rin lang. Parang, konti lang. Mahal eh. It's expensive, y'all. So,
Gano ka konti?
Siguro 75 pairs.
But you just said that they were lying about
so
the 75 pairs.
So therefore, that means, yeah. So,
yeah.
Ano yan? Estimate ko lang.
Conservative.
Yan.
Kumbaga, yun yung nasuot mo for the past 75 days. So, okay, 75
It's so
pairs.
Funny though. Everything that they were saying is so true. Like, I know we want to talk about something else, but I just want to say the calendar bit about knowing yung rotation. Ma'am, ginagawa ko yun. Kasi, or rotate mo eh. Parang hindi ko pa nasusot itong month na to. So, tapos, I'm talking about Jordan. So, let's say, kahit, yun, mismo. Itong True Blue, tagal lang hindi. Tapos, hanap ka ng, siyempre, bit by bit na yan eh. Yung wardrobe mo.
Terno.
Balik po siya, pre. Balik that ground. Ground up. Oo, dictates. Ito pa yung secret. On feet. Yeah. So, check ko eh. Would Kanye wear this? Okay, ah. Pwede, pwede. So, yun. All right, moving on.
Damn, we should just talk about sneakers on this episode.
Yeah.
I didn't know it was such a fun topic.
It is.
I didn't know that.
Hours, when you have Jago on
hours of fun and enjoyment.
Hours of fun and enjoyment and talking about their passions, right? Well, speaking of passion, we know that everyone knows that you're the guitarist of Sandwich and also play, you make your own music with the Diegos, with your brother.
Yes, I do.
So how'd you start with your music career? Like, it's such a different, it's two different
what
genres.
What are you asking? The music career in terms of DJing?
Or both.
Well, I started playing. The first band that I was in was a band called the Agamulak Experience.
Which Why was, did you name that?
Because back then I was in, let's just pretend I was in high school. Uh-huh. And Agamulak was super popular. And we thought like, oh, this would be a fun name to name your band. And the shtick of our band was that all of us had Mulaks as last name. So I would be Jago Mulak. And then half of Sandwich, Myrene was part of that. Okay. And then we had Tony Dalmashan, who runs Terna Records. Are you familiar with the...
Yeah, last week we had Yolanda.
So there you go. He was our drummer because I was interning at the record store. Anyway, so that was my first ever band. And just for fun, you know, we were just like... It was a punk rock band. We'd do like a lot of crazy stuff. You've seen some of the pictures at home, so... And then Sandwich basically happened because we used to play with... Raymond Marasigan's other band called Planet Karapata, Planet Chi. So we would be booked Agamulak at the old Club Dread. And then he was a fan, oddly enough, of like, because he went up to us and like, because we were wearing matching costumes, we had dye yung buhok. And then he said like, oh, man, we should like do something in the future. Which of course I thought just was being nice. Fast forward maybe like 3 years later, I'm working at a record company, BMG Records, and one of my clients is of course the Eraserheads. And he says like, dude, let's do it. So that's how Sandwich was born. He got Agamulak, like basically like Agamulak Experience plus him and Mark Abaya at that time.
Half of
so
it.
So that is Sandwich.
That's crazy.
Damn, so it really just goes back to...
Since the dawn of time! Because your eyes are getting big. You're like trying to figure out, what am I going to say?
What? That was so long ago.
But I was 10, though. I was 10.
Yeah, so in high school.
Yeah, it was. I was 10, yeah.
10 in high school.
Yeah. Club Dread.
Yeah, Club Dread. Mm.
What year is Jordan 3? 88. Isipin mo, no? 88.
Ako, pinanganak ako ng 89.
Sama mo. Ako rin, hindi ko alam yun. Kinwento lang sana kapatid Joe, man. Why do you think I buy these shoes? So I couldn't afford them when I was a kid. I didn't catch them, man. So
now that you actually can and you're old enough to afford it, you...
I'm just learning from the past. Just learning, you have to learn...
Your kapatid.
Yeah, everything. Uh-huh. Music, fashion. So yeah, I didn't... Who's Michael Jordan? All right.
And so, speaking of your kapatid, how did the Diego start?
Well, Jago Mapa I've known for the longest time because we've been in bands since forever. He used to be in a band called Monster Bot, and of course he's with Pedicab. But back in the day, here we go again. Back in the day, I used to write for a TV show, and he was one of my talents. Mm-hmm. He was an artista. He was like he was one of my talents. And then we used to score music for Quarkinarsa's films, like, and then we got into DJing the same time because we got booked at do you remember, are you too young to remember Flux? Like, and along, man, the old, very good. It was in a place called the Manila DJs Club. So that was where our DJing career began. Because the people who ran it were the artist Kiko Ascora and designer Gian Romano was also part of that. Tapos they just booked people who didn't really know how to DJ. parang for fun. Like, so yeah. I didn't really know. So you press play, and then...
Ang saya nun!
Segway mo, right? And then that's how it began. So he was booked the same time I did. So sabay kami. And then because we kept on... Then we started like learning how to do it, learning how to beat match. Eventually, sabi na, Chong, lagi tayo magkasama as individuals. Magdikit kaya tayo na parang some crazy group. Crazy group, right? So that's how the Jagos really began. So does that make sense?
Yeah. That kind of does. Wow.
It does. So as well, may question kami.
They,
parang
they got like deer in headlights, y'all. George.
No, I'm kidding.
Ano ang difference ng Diego Castillo ng sandwich?
Gusto ko yan.
From the Diego Castillo ng
parang ano? All right, nang
yeah.
Nang the Diegos.
Ah, oh, magandang tanong yan. Siyempre. gusto ko na ganyan. Vale, obviously, for Sandwich, we're performing original music. Mm-hmm. And it's a collective. If you're asking me, as the Diegos, we're not... We throw in a few remixes that we've made ourselves, but yeah. That's few and far between. We've done like 4 or 5 re-edits, remixes. But generally, for the three-hour set, I'm playing 90% somebody else's music.
True.
As opposed to Sandwich we're in. And I'm also playing guitar versus just, machine, you know, machine. Yeah. But the misconception is that you have a couple of decks and then you're a DJ. It's a craft. You learn. It's a skill. Like, beat matching is a skill. DJing is a skill. Kasi people always claim like, dali niya kasi.
Hindi pwede basta-basta.
Oh, basta-basta eh. Meron naman akong, but it's not. That's why I like it a lot because medyo cerebral lang siya. So you have to learn how to match everything together and how it works and how the effects work. Doesn't mean that you know how to press a phaser.
Yun na yun.
Di ba? Yeah. May placement yan eh, sa chorus or something. So,
it's just like what we were telling DJ Buddha a few weeks back, that it's like another instrument,
yeah,
no?
Yeah.
That you have to learn and master.
True. Tsaka, like, yun pa yung kay Buddha when it comes to him, like, technical na, like, scratch.
Oh, he does, like, that. He does, like, yeah, yeah, he does. DJ, see, that's like another that. Thing.
Uh-huh.
Yung, magkaiba pa yung art form na yan sa ginagawa ko. My favorite DJ, maybe, is DJ Shadow. Kasi he does everything. He scratches so incredibly well. But then, He does like the sets where in chill lang eh. Ay, bebe, yeah. Like, yeah.
What's your most favorite style when you DJ? Like, is there a style like
the crab style is pretty good. Pretty
well,
crab style is pretty good, yo. Crab style. Yo, crab style.
It does kind of feel good. You have to try.
I'm sorry. You were asking me what sort of style in
Like you were talking, there's scratch and there's
no charge,
chill,
help
right?
Me out. Oh no, I don't know how to scratch. I do know how to scratch, but then not brave enough to actually do it in a live set.
Yeah. Okay.
What we do is we just sort of, in a nutshell, what I think DJing is about, at least for us, is that you get to a venue, hindi ka ang bida ron. Your job is to make sure that all the kids there have a good time. Right? So it's not about, technically it's really not about you. Yeah. So you try to figure out, you look out in the audience and you think like, ano kaya yung sounds sa trip nila? So if I see RJ there, you know, then maybe I'll drop in a song that I know he'll like, or if I see George there, if I see, so it's that sort of thing. So you try to make everybody happy, kasi nagbabayad naman sila, and you don't want them to have not a good time naman. So that's it, you know, so that's sort of in a nutshell.
So your job is to make everyone else enjoy.
Oh, ikaw yung ano ng party. Uh-oh. Ikaw nagkikreate ng vibe. Tapos
yeah.
Uuwi na silang lahat. Sandung ka pa rin. Last 4 na umaga.
Nag-ano ka na. Lilipit ka ng gamit.
Oh, no. Ang trick pa is you start at a slow BPM. Maybe like 85.
Mm-hmm.
85 would be like a hip-hop BPM, right? Tapos aabot ka ng 130s, kahagulo na. Tapos bababa na naman. Tapos uuwi na lahat ng tao. Pero kailangan mo pang tapusin yun. Tingin, wala nang tao dito.
That happened to me like at an event, and we had a really not so good DJ. I was hosting. Tapos lahat ng tao nakikita mo sila, they were leaving. They were slowly leaving. So it's such a big job for the DJs to actually mahuli nila yung gusto ng tao they'll stay and enjoy.
But sometimes it takes a long time to figure it out. There's like venues wherein I've never spun before and it's a different audience. You're probably, no offense to, let's say, let's not mention the lang music, but then, you know, somebody's gonna ask you for a song that I just don't play.
Mm-hmm.
So mahirap kasi then you're trying, and what I realized that if I lie, they think it's the thing pala.
Said somebody comes up, dude, play blank and blank.
Oh, yeah.
So, then, sila ngayon, I'm sorry, I don't have it. Pero ngayon, sabihin ko, coming up, pero iba, soul wax pa play. Tapos parang gagawin ako sa kanya, sila, that's the trick!
Nakuha mo yung secret, ha?
Kasi yun pala yun. Yeah. They don't, so, minsan ganda, minsan hindi talaga nag-work talaga. Parang ayaw nila.
But when it does work, it feels good.
It does, though.
Yun yung, like, pansin ko, parang yun yung pinaka-challenging sa mga
deals. Sobra.
Kasi minsan, parang na-frustrate ka na, parang, ano bang gagawin ko, diba? Parang,
sobra.
Request, tapos paulit-ulit. Minsan, tapos paulit-ulit pa, mabalik-balik sila.
Tapos, hinahabol-habol mo yung tracks, tapos, tinacheck mo yung mukha ng party. Kasi yung pinakamalaking group of people, medyo gusto mo, yun yung patuwain mo eh. Pag meron ka na din rap, nagkagulo sila, tapos ang saya na feeling, yun na! Dali na to, ganun. So, that's it. So, gandang story yan.
Magandang story, yes.
Dami ko magandang story sa mga ganyan eh.
And speaking of fun shows nga, ano yung wildest thing na nangyari na sa any show that you played at? Sorry, nahuli.
We've done like crazy sets, like for, meron parang spaceship na 360.
Wild.
Na, pa, nangyari, even though the Diego siya, hindi kami makatabi ni Diego mapa. So, I can see him right across. Sagutan kami ng from really this big ass stage, yung masaya, tapos yung tao underneath. Parang futuristic, ganun. Masaya. Yun, that's like one of those crazy shows. We did this in, huwag natin mention yung may sponsor. Like, that's fun. And then we had like another, I remember distinctly being so nervous opening for a big rock event. Uh-huh. Because generally, people don't think na, which is not true. Of course, it's true. But then you think like, 20,000 people nanood ng rock concert. Ang opening act, the Diegos. So, sabi ko, nako, man. Patay tayo dito kasi you're gonna start off na, no? Pero sobra kong tuwa kasi sobrang responsive ng kids. That's why you also should never parang think that the audience naman is, doesn't know
stereotyping.
So, kasi gustong-gusto, sasayaw naman sila eh. O, tsaka, ang rock naman may dance vibe naman yan. Hip-hop's the same thing. It's the same thing. So, parang, sayaw naman nila. Tapos, mamaya ko, ante, ano na, may nagaganong-ganon. So, saya. Mas ayoko na. Parang, tapos na kayo. Pero, that was fun. You know, those were kind of memorable shows. And, yeah, yun. I've also played LA, by the way. So, that's a pretty,
as an individual.
Yes!
Yo, what up?
LA.
Oh, and I opened for Tega. In Singapore.
Hindi ko alam yun, ha?
Are, wala si Diego Maps na. Ako lang yun, ha?
Solo lang ako na.
Hindi kayo nagtitingin ng Instagram, eh. Ano ba naman, no? But that was, yun yata yung pinaka nakakasuka, yung sa LA. Kasi, wala kang pala, eh.
What?
Meaning, you don't have a crew. You're not bringing in George. You're not bringing in anybody.
So you parang, just fly solo ka lang talaga.
Tsaka, wala. So, well, Raymond was there. Raymond Marasigan was there. Kasi we had actually played a show. Sandwich was in LA. And so I booked this show.
Na so sabay.
Racket ko, di ba? Parang bubook ko to. Tapos dating ko doon, nasusoka na ako. Kasi, nakakatakot eh. Totoo. Tsaka, iba yung vibe. Malalaki yung mga tao eh.
Tapos hindi mo sila kilala.
Pero masaya din. Parang, ganun din eh. You know what saved me though is Tribe Called Quest.
What?
As usual, yun yung icebreaker. Magpasok nun, parang kagulo na sila, okay na tayo, pwede ka na mag-electro, tinakbo ko na kung saan-saan. Tapos, that was fun.
Tribe Called Quest parang sekreto din. So, teka lang, I wanna call on my roommate, George. Yo! Mukhang masaya pag nandito si George eh.
Yeah!
Yan, no?
What up?
Guys, meet George. This is George, my roommate below.
What's up, George?
So, yan, George.
Hey, same.
How you doing?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Good.
I didn't recognize you without the cap, but you look good.
Appreciate that. My God. Give me on my good side. Right. So what are we talking about?
So
here are my questions. Wait. Well, so okay, tell us about yourself, y'all.
Well, I'm a young entrepreneur.
All right.
I like to think that I'm still in my teenage years, but obviously.
But you aren't, aren't you?
Huh?
Aren't you still in your teenage years?
I'm a heartbreaker. I'm not doing too much out here, man. I'm just loving the people out here and getting to know everyone. Joyce, Arge, Diego.
Do you have other jobs?
Do I have any other jobs?
Yeah.
Why, yes, I actually do.
Are you a male gigolo? A male gigolo?
I actually have been on Quezon Avenue a few times.
That doesn't make you a male gigolo.
He flew out to Paris and Germany last week.
Oh yeah, that was fun. That was a lot of fun.
I saw your arty pictures, y'all.
Thanks, man.
You have the artiest.
So what do you think about Instagram?
The truth?
Yes.
I love it though. I don't know why. Because I don't do Twitter or I don't do
no social media.
Nah. And it's just because you don't have to pretend to be, you just put a picture. I don't have to lie and say like, la na ko isipin eh.
Post na lang eh. Picture, boom. Diba?
Like yours, man. Birds in flight. Birds in flight.
Okay. No. Thanks, man.
Yeah, it's so arty.
Well, I actually been thinking of a few questions that
What do you think of Instagram?
What do I think about Instagram? I think it's just a big photo gallery. I think it's for those who just want to put out some work and whatever they see and they want to capture, then they can just share it. That's why I love the internet as it is.
Yeah, sorry. What do you think about selfies, though?
Selfie. How about we just take a group selfie right now? How about we just post it? Yeah, let's post it right now. Hey, follow us.
Follow George.
I don't even follow you on Instagram.
It's all right.
I know. We follow each other. I follow all of y'all.
Well, I'm gonna follow you guys out of here after we do this. How about we do?
Yeah.
We're gonna do it.
I don't hashtag though, guys.
You should.
One, two, three. Ay, Dios mío. Okay, that's nice, yo.
Now tell people where they can find that photo.
Balo Squared on Instagram. I don't know how to plug in those things. I'm sorry, I'm really awful at this. My bad, guys.
Plug in what?
I had plugging like Instagram IDs and all
just,
that.
Just say
spell
that
it out or something because it's complicated.
Oh, it's Balo Squared. Okay, I thought you were serious. My bad. Anyways.
Last one, Joseph.
Yo, I have something else to George. Like, let him do something else. Like,
George is very entertaining.
Dance.
I just heard this.
Let's do this. No, quick question, man. I've been, you know, I was over there just minding my own business. I was thinking, like, do you prefer, like, blondes or redheads or brunettes?
I'm so serious right now. I never really thought about it.
Okay,
so,
well, let's take a time to talk about it. Let's ponder and maybe just banter a little bit.
I don't think I've ever really seen like a true blue. I've never been with like a true blue blonde. So.
Oh, yeah.
This is natural.
I'm sorry. So.
It's really natural.
It's really hot.
Then I love it. This is it.
Cool. That's really
nice. Like, and a bit of black.
Yeah.
Brunette inside.
Okay. It's naturally like, ombre.
I'm sorry, what's it called?
Ombre.
What is that?
You know the ones where they have like two different colors on their hair? It's called ombre.
Okay.
Right?
Is it French?
I have no fucking idea, but it sounds fancy.
You're a foul-mouthed woman, do you know that?
Welcome to PurveyrTV.
Welcome to PurveyrTV.
I love PurveyrTV.
Fuck this shit.
I feel like, oh man, I'm still coming off a cold, so I don't have my...
I heard you. I felt so bad for you. You
were like... My Vandross voice right now. I kind of sound like Al Green.
I think they're cutting us off.
Are we getting cut off?
I think it's time to go.
No.
They pushed us out? Oh, I'm sorry, guys. Well, let's get coffee.
10 more minutes.
UCC or Starbucks?
Ooh. Neither for me.
Coffee bean.
Coffee bean. I have the card. I think Diego wants alcohol.
I tell you what, though.
What has alcohol done to your career?
Truth.
Give it to them.
No. Alcohol for my career?
Yes.
It's made my career. Because I can't play guitar or DJing or any of that stuff without the power of alcohol.
How about you guys?
Isn't that so bad?
Has alcohol done anything to change how you go about your career? It's an upper?
Yeah. I chug a shot down before I enter. Like,
you're lying.
I'm not.
How about we just... That's not a shot. First of all, that's not...
What's a shot then? It looks bigger because your hands are bigger. I was just doing this. Okay? It's a shot.
you took a shot of alcohol.
Yeah, like I saw. That's,
me too. I had four beers.
Have you tried that?
And no. I'm not even joking. Like
I'm not even joking. I did too. And I was in school then. My teachers asked me to eat chocolates because apparently it takes the shit out of your system.
Oh, why are you so foul mouth?
I don't know. It's because of George.
I'm sorry for being here. Anyways, there's something that people don't know about you, and it's your love for the NBA.
Yes. Yeah. Can you?
So oh my God. Okay.
Oh my God. Okay.
Okay.
Predictions.
So this is Diego's thing. I've never met anyone like him, and I thought it was, you know, just surreal to ever experience something like this. But you can actually tell Diego, you can list the player and he'll tell you the stats of him or the history.
Oh, this is too difficult. Now I'm not drunk.
Huh?
Okay, go ahead.
We'll get a six pack if you want, dude. Okay, this is entertaining.
I will see.
We'll just do a few players for fun.
But I might freeze. I mean,
okay. Kevin Garnett.
See, that's 7 feet, 285. Where's his high school from? I don't remember. No, Garnett came straight from high school. That's Tim Duncan. Tim Duncan, 7 feet, 265. Number 21. First pick, 2004.
Awesome.
Okay. But where did Garnett go to high school?
See, that's what I don't know. That's what I thought. I was betting on you knowing. Carmelo.
Syracuse, 6'9", 245. He did go to Syracuse. He won the national champion. He was an MVP and the champion in his freshman year.
And he went straight to the NBA afterwards.
That draft had D. Wade, Chris Bosh.
One of the most talented pools.
Of course. Are you Lakers fans, obviously?
Lakers fan. No? Lakers fan.
Good. Yo!
Guys, anyone? Thunder! Thunder! Just let me tell you about the epic nights that me and Arj have when playing NBA 2K. It's pretty discouraging to our love lives. But hi, babe. Anyways, we are on there furiously for hours.
Yeah. I've seen you kids.
I always wanted to play. Oh, wow. Oh,
wow. I think RJ didn't even say hello to me.
Oh, like, hello,
I was there for 4 hours and he's like doing this shit. I'm like, okay. Oh, and tsaka naka-turbo kayo all
the way. Oo, naka-turbo kami nun.
Comedic yung, dapat chill.
And he tried to get your attention, you were just like this.
Yeah.
Hold on.
I'm sorry. But you don't remember, right?
So awesome.
I don't.
I'm there, I'm like saying, what
I know,
up?
I said.
What up? You're just like. Come on. And all I can hear, I think you only gave the ball to Durant. Right?
Oh, hindi naman. Oh, hindi naman.
That's it.
So it's not even the real OKC.
Grabe naman.
Man, tsaka binabang parang 25 three-pointers. Pare, kailangan yung...
Pero pasok lang.
Kailangan may suspension of disbelief. Parang totoong laro. Yung mabaga lang.
Parang papasok ko dapat kay Perkins, ganun.
Oh, wag. Tanga yun eh. We played ball.
Yeah, we did.
Where was I?
Bam, we played for Bam, right? Team Sunday and
I'm not an artist though.
Lockdown yeah. Entertainment.
Okay. Joyce saw us play ball as well.
Yeah, I have in my high school years.
Do you play?
Yeah.
Oh my God. Okay, that's pretty cool. I didn't think she was gonna say yes, but all right.
I did in my high school years.
Did you take a shot before?
No. After.
Like a little bit loosey-goosey.
Yeah. No, I did actually. And wakeboarding. That's the only thing I knew how
that's
to do.
That's solid.
Yeah.
Wakeboarding? I never heard this sport.
Boarding.
Before. Oh, so you're not listening.
You're not paying attention, dude. Like,
wakeboarding? That's too much information, Joyce.
Oh, since I'm originally from Washington, D.C.
So you're a Wizards fan?
I am a Wizards fan, which is a given. I just want you to tell them about. Bad brains.
Bad Brains are the best hardcore band ever.
I just wanted people to hear that.
The best hardcore band ever. And they're Rastafarian African Americans performing super souped up like funk. They started off as they used to do like James Brown covers.
That's from DC.
Yeah.
band in DC.
That's the best hardcore band of all time.
Bad How come Brits. You never told me about them, George?
How come you never asked?
Wow.
Fugazi. Another of your, oh that's God. The same from, that's the a diamond Discord in the Discord records are also from your area. So those are all like the hardcore, body hardcore. Sama yan. Hardcore, hip hop.
Spatan gaya na.
Alam mo lang yan. Parang ano yan eh. Ang grabe mo alam siya nga. So,
natutunan ko yung kay Diego eh. Kay Diego ko yung kay George natutunan eh.
Well, actually talking about, I said downloading. Quick question. I wanted viewers to actually hear this. How has downloading or sharing music or the internet in itself changed your approach at music?
The truth? Obviously, when I was younger, there was no internet. I'm not going to lie.
Right.
So we were making music, and the only way wherein kids could actually hear it was either on the radio or actually buy the damn thing. Okay. I don't find any problems whatsoever. It's the greatest tool ever. You know, ever, I think, because then it gets out there, people hear it, you can download it, I already know they are, but I think that the true blue fan, like myself, like you, I assume you're gonna buy like the real hard copy past a certain point because you want it. So,
I bought RJ's album.
Oh,
I'm a true blue fan.
No, it's I think that it's, I don't see any qualms with it at all.
Okay,
it's like I don't know, it's like borrowing a book,
but it is true.
If I lent you my book. And you read it, so am I supposed to be? I don't know. And I make music, so it's not really that
true,
big a
true.
Deal. I
mean, do you agree?
I
What's your take? Way, man. I feel like you don't.
I think it's definitely changed the perception on how people make music. They tend to see it as a way of selling themselves, or they really lost the art for making what they wanted to do as musicians. So purity
Who's they?
I don't know. I'm just trying to put them in a box.
Okay, all right.
This is me just thinking out loud.
No, I hear you.
And then, you know, and they see it as a selling point. And, you know, you see all these dance records and whatnot. Mm-hmm. I don't think these people as musicians would really make music like that before. But since they see it as a selling point that they can, you know, make, you know, eat and support their families.
So it's
make
like,
music like that.
It's just so... It's consumer driven, as you're saying. Like, I come home, we can, the three of us, in 30 minutes, come up with a track, sell it. Is that what you mean? See, I agree, and I totally believe it. Much like there's so many bands that they're just shit. I mean, I'm not gonna lie. But I really think that true talent, people are not stupid. You can hear stuff, and you know what's good, and you know what isn't. And so I don't wanna discount that kids are stupid just because we churned out 1 million songs, that they all gotta be good, y'all.
Word,
you know what I'm saying? Like,
word.
So I think you're a smart guy. You know what? This one rocks. This one I know has integrity. This one sounds like shit. This one was did in 30 minutes.
This is real.
This is real. Wow.
For sure.
That's why, especially coming from DC, the hardcore stuff, that's where it's all rooted from. But I don't know if because I caught the era prior to that, maybe you're right if you're 15 now and you don't know, but I think you will though. I think if you're, does that make sense? Or am
I? Absolutely.
I
think we need a drink after this.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
All right. Well, sorry for wasting your time, guys.
It will never happen again. Goodbye.
That was fun. Thanks, Diego. Do you have like Twitter and Instagram to plug?
Yeah.
Are your shows coming up?
Shows, we're playing, this is perfect, Sandwich and the Diegos are playing this Saturday at, where's that piazza thing? You can help me out here.
Oh, yeah.
Thank
Venice
you,
Piazza.
Venice.
The summer sunset party.
Yeah, we're doing that. Yeah. So Sandwich, Pedicab, and the Diegos as well. So perfect. That would be nice.
What about you, Arch? Any shows coming up?
Well, not really right now, but we're shooting the new video for Abra, the Illusion.
Nice.
Yeah, we're shooting. Kakatapos lang nung shoot last night. Tapos next week, we're gonna be shooting LDP scene for it. So, yeah.
But, no wonder you guys weren't home last night.
I was home last night.
Home?
Yeah. Si Joe tsaka si Marge yung wala sa bahay.
And I heard Joyce was into music too.
Yeah, I'm going to sing after this break.
Yeah.
I can't wait. I've been waiting like all afternoon for this. So let's see.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, George.
Thanks, George.
Do you have anything to tell the viewers, George?
Twitter?
It was fun. That's all.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
That's it. Oh my Instagram. It's Dayglow1, I think.
Yes,
it is. Dayglow1, and that's it. I think I have a Twitter account, but I don't remember if it's
Dayglow. Castillo.
Try Dayglow Castillo.
Yeah.
All right, guys. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much.
So right now, so we got a very, very... Break. Okay, after the break... We got a very, very break. Okay, yula.
What you've been missing on the factory.
Now we're gonna show you guys the new beta that just came out yesterday. It's God of War Ascension, the private beta.
For PlayStation Plus.
PlayStation Plus.
Let's watch it, right? It's not, it's Enrico playing already.
Yes.
Yep.
There you go, and perfect timing.
Perfect timing. But before that, I was kicking ass.
So go with the theme of the show, How Not to Play.
It's Robot Rice and Friends with Alfonso Martinez, Mickey Han, and Nigel Zalameo. Fridays, 6 to 7 p.m., only here on The Factory.
Hi, everybody. I'm Bianca Valerio.
I'm Julia Snigowski.
I'm Trisha Santanera.
And we are the girls of 28!
Okay, so you have to be wondering, what on earth is 28?
Exactly, so find out every Sunday night, 8-9. Hang out with us. Mm-hmm. We're going to be talking about everything under the sun.
Girls, boys,
boobs, boobs. Okay, that's fine.
Both you say boobs.
Of course, yeah.
For sure. You can call us, we will give you a phone.
We want to talk to you guys, too.
Yeah. Eventually, the phone number will come.
But since in the meantime, we can't figure out the whole podcasting figure spot, but we're trying to figure out voice,
what you've been missing on The Factory.
Were you the one who posted, James, regarding the guidelines when it comes to checkpoints?
Yes, I
That's
was.
That's fantastic.
Yes, I just made it up, but you know, I thought it was
made it up. What do you mean made it up?
I mean, this time of year, right? Elections. You know, you never let the truth get in the way of a good story, okay? Children, do not follow this at home. I'm just kidding. Just so you know your rights, if you do get stopped by a checkpoint,
you're not allowed
we're able to verify all of these, James.
You're not allowed to run over them. That didn't make it here. So technically, now, number two, upon approach, slow down. I guess that counts as not running them over. Dim headlights and slow turn down. On cabin lights. Okay.
Cabin lights. Mm-hmm.
Lock all doors of vehicles during inspection.
Since lock?
Lock.
They might get pissed off because nope. You're locking.
But that's the thing. Okay. This is where they get you. And this is actually, I know we're making fun of it a little bit, but yeah. This is a serious issue. We've seen some people genuinely harassed. Drugs are planted.
Yeah,
and other things, stories. You know. A Justin Bieber CD is planted, which is even worse.
Oh,
yes,
no.
I've heard of that, you know. And there's no defense for that. There's really no defense. Yeah, it's like, but Your Honor, we found this. Throw the book at him. The CD as well.
Then after that, you have to submit your cell phone and everything. Yeah. And next thing you know, you have a Justin Bieber ringtone.
Catch James Deacon and the Boys on Counterflow Wednesday, 7:30 to 8:30, only here on The Fact. Oh my
God. I'm just... Sup. What's up, y'all? I'm gonna do... I can't do it. No. Okay. I'm gonna do covers, because that's all I can do. Dude. Okay. Game. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. You know, I'm only singing because Marvin has no other choice. This is where I come in. I let it fall, my heart, and as it fell, you rose to claim me. It was dark, and I was over, until you kissed my lips, and you saved me. My hands, they're strong, but my knees were far too weak to stay. Demure bigla, thanks. One more daw. So, hindi naman nasisira yung mga araw nyo, no? Pwede na. Guys, hindi nasisira yung araw nyo. Give it up once again for Gabby's Closet and Diego Castillo for being with us. Woo! For Bayer TV. When the sales come first, the truth comes second, just stop for a minute and smile. Why is everybody so serious, acting so damn mysterious? Got shades on your eyes, your heels so high, you can't even have a good time. So everybody look to your left, and everybody look to your right. Can you feel the air? We're filled with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need you. Money, 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 we just wanna make the world dance. Forget about them price tag. Ain't about the, cha-ching, cha-ching. Ain't about the, ba-bing, ba-bing. Wanna make the world dance. Forget about them price tag, yeah. We need to take it back in time, when music made us all unite. And it was the logos and video. The only one getting tired. Why is everybody so obsessed? Money can buy us happiness. Can we all slow down and enjoy right now? Guaranteed we'll be feeling aye. So everybody look to your left, and everybody look to your right. Can you feel it? We'll be with love tonight. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the the price tag. Ain't about the oh, ain't about the a. We wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Yeah, yeah, we'll keep the price tag and take your cash back. Just give me six strings and a half set. We can keep the cars, leave me the garage. And all I, yes, all I need are keys and guitars. And guess what? In 30 seconds, I'm leaving Mars. Yeah, we're leaping across this undefeatable odds. It's like this, man, you can't put a price on the life. We do this for the love, so we fight and sacrifice every night. So we ain't gonna stumble and fall, never. We in the sea, this is the sign of defeat. So we gon' keep moving our feet. So bring back the beat. And then everyone says, not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. We just wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. Ain't about the oh, ain't about the hey. We wanna make the world dance. Forget about the price tag. It's not about the money, money, money. We don't need your money, money, money. I'm happy. Come on up here, boys. Come on, everyone. Okay, I'm just gonna stick with the mic stand because it's twirled. Here. We're all here.
So,
galing ah.
Galing.
Galing Joyce.
Yay! I'm happy. Thanks, Joyce. Wait, is that on? Is it on? Is that even on?
Yan.
Is it on?
Yan, on na. Yes. Yan.
See? It was off, man.
Ay, hindi nila narinig.
That was a fun... ulitin mo yung sinabi mo.
Ang lupit pala ni Joyce.
Galing,
galing, galing, galing. Yan, narinig na nila.
From RJULVP, I feel so legit, man. Okay. Thank you guys for being with us here.
Thank
it was
having,
such
thank
a
you for
fun
having us.
Thank you guys. Yeah.
Thank
solid,
you.
Solid.
Super
solid,
fun.
Solid.
Yay.
Have us back. Tomorrow.
Yes.
Let's do shout-outs. Shout-outs. Shout out to
Team Gabby's Closet. Again, we're located at Unit 2M1, Lee Gardens Condominium, Shaw Boulevard, Mandaluyong City. Word up.
Nice.
George.
Shout out to Secret Service, yeah, Ronak yes. Arts Center, Unschooled, Progress, THE, all the fam out there doing the thing. Just keep doing you.
Diego.
I just want to say hello, y'all. I had nothing to do today. Thank you for bringing me here. All right.
Thank you, Purveyor.
Well, we want to thank Purveyor TV. Well, we enjoyed Diego,
yes,
George.
Yes, thank you, thank you. No, you're right.
And the staff, the crew, thank you so much. I want to say hi to my mom and to all the sneakerheads out there. Hello. That's it.
Yeah, so Joyce.
Shout out to my realist. Okay, we're just gonna hold this like it's some fan sign. Please check out www.purveyor.com and also follow us on Twitter, Purveyor, and you can use the hashtag PurveyorTV if you have any comments, suggestions, and love to let us know about our show. Our Facebook also is PurveyorTV. That's one word. You can follow me on Twitter at Joyce Pring.
Follow me on Twitter at Deranged Poet.
And see you again next week. Same time, same place. Thank you again, guys, for being
thank
here.
You. Thanks for having us. Guys.
Yeah, PurveyorTV.
Yes. Last shout out to Ruby Ibarra. Last week, we did a show with her before she left for the States. So, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Salamat. Yeah, thanks, Ruby.
Started from the bottom, now we
can. Yeah. This has been your host. I'm Joyce.
RJ.
Purveyor TV out.
One.